I say this thing is worth every penny. It's worth every penny. This basically helps your car get that instant power to the core of your engine without having any restrictions whatsoever. What's going on YouTube? This is Bruce with Bruce Custom Motors, bringing you guys another official video. All right guys, in this video, we're gonna be doing a follow-up on the IE intake manifold. A lot of people have asked me and have been wondering about, was this mod worth it for my vehicle? As you guys know from my previous video, and if you didn't see the video, please watch it. I'm going to leave a link to the video at the end and also up here. So if you guys are wondering what this is and the reason why I got it, make sure you watch that video. But I'm just going to give you a quick snippet on it. So this is going to be an IE intake manifold, and I did a complete install video on this. My purpose for getting this is because I have a custom Stage 3 Plus tuned from IE, and I needed something that can help me get more horsepower and where my car can breathe a little bit more. As you guys know from my install video, the traditional OEM intake manifold has flaps in it. And so those actual flaps that they have in that intake manifold reduces the airflow that goes into the engine and you lose some of your horsepower. A lot of people don't know this, but the actual 2.0 engine, which is essentially the same one in the S3, is actually a down-tuned engine from the manufacturer for warranty purposes, longevity, etc. I try to tell a lot of people, if you tune the vehicle, you can put how much horsepower that you want on that vehicle. Whatever you tell that computer, it will give your vehicle. But the ultimate goal is, can your engine, can your internals handle the horsepower that you tell it to give? Because of course, if you say, hey computer, I want you to go 10,000 RPM. I want you to go max RPMs on every shift. You're gonna eventually blow up your engine. So you wanna make sure that you're moderate when you're transitioning your tune on your vehicle, which essentially is what a custom tune is, so that way you can know what your engine can handle and what it can't handle. So just to get back on track, so my take on the IE intake manifold, I think it's amazing, I think it's awesome. So getting back on track, my purpose for this was to get more airflow into my engine and get rid of those flaps. And if you're not ready to spend the money on the IE intake manifold, HPA intake manifold, they do have a runner flap delete that you can use on your 1.8, your 2.0s, and maybe even your 3.0s, to where you can get more airflow into your engine and hence more horsepower. So what I've noticed is once I put the IE intake manifold on my vehicle, I have an extremely responsive throttle response when I'm pressing on the gas. It's like I'm almost like an NA, which is naturally aspirated, because once I touch the pedal, it's like my car is ready to take on the power. It's just like instant. Before, when I would press the pedal, there'd be a big turbo lag or a surge in my vehicle, and this just extremely just kind of cut that off immediately, to where I get that instant torque and response. This, along with the sprint booster, makes me feel like I literally have an NA vehicle. When I say this thing is worth every penny, it's worth every penny, especially if you're going to, you know, add a KO4 to your vehicle, or if you have plans for your vehicle whatsoever. The factory flaps are designed to moderate the amount of pressure coming into the engine. Just to let you guys know, if you do get this intake manifold, you can run it, but you will have a check engine light. You can run it, but you will have a check engine light for this right here. This is gonna be the intake manifold sensor. So you will have a check engine light unless you tuned for it. So I tuned for this, and essentially when you tune for this, basically what you're doing is you're telling the computer to basically skip your cold start. So there's a brief 2 minute segment when you start your car to where your car is trying to warm itself up. This essentially will skip that cold start stage and get right to the core and the meat of the power for your vehicle. So you will have to tune for it. If you don't tune for it, you're gonna have a very rough cold start. Your car will drive normal, but that first cold start will be very, very rough if you do not tune for it. But prior to me doing this, I didn't tune for it and I was running it. I just would have that rough cold start in the morning. Then eventually the next starts were fine once the engine was warmed up. So just keep that in mind. You do need to tune for it. I chose IE over HPA because I know at the present time, HPA was kind of getting out a few kinks and IE is just really out there. They have some really self-assured product, but I definitely would say that this is a bang for your buck. Like I said, and if you need to save up for this or you plan on getting this, you definitely can do the runner flap delete on your vehicle and that will help it as well. I can definitely say this gave me more horsepower. I can definitely say this gave me more torque. And I can definitely say this is one of the best mods that I got for my vehicle to help me gain that horsepower. I'm sure if you guys watched my video, you've seen the whole install, like I said. I just like to do follow-up videos a couple months later on all of the build parts that I do just to let you guys know how it's doing. Was it worth it? You know, my take on it. You know, I'm like the guinea pig for the family and for the Audi community to where I'm going to put it on the vehicle. I'm going to give you guys a true assessment of my views on it so you can know what you need to do if you decide to do it or if it's something that you want to do. So I'm always going to give you those pros and I'm always going to give you those cons. And also just another great thing about this is, you know, like I said before, I'm able to just instantly put my boost tap right over here. So this is going to be my boost tap. And so yeah, that helps. It comes with all of the slots that you need for the boost tap. And also it's a lot bigger, so you have more airflow and more air being forced into your engine. So yeah, just wanted to share that with you guys. Hope you guys like the video. Make sure you like and subscribe. If you have a request for any specific video or topic, promise I will get back with you guys as soon as I can. I do have a lot of viewers, a lot of subscribers. So I try my best to be moderate to answer those key questions, but I do take time to do them. So just let me know. Appreciate all love and support. This was Bruce with Bruce Custom Motors. Peace, I'm out.